What's up, guys? This is Link6694
and Wolf1225,
and today we're reviewing Copter Crisis, which is 500 Wii points on WiiWare, developed by Digital Leisure. So, if we could summarize this review in one word, what would it be?
I would have to say mediocre.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's get on to the review. So, anyway, the graphics will be the first thing that we discuss. Now, the graphics are, like he said earlier, mediocre, and they basically just use the same design for every single level in the terms of a canyon. And I mean the design, because you're always in a canyon. That's what I mean, because the level designs themselves, like the different paths, are always different. One of the interesting things is one of the levels you have to carry toys to a toy store in the canyon. Okay, I don't know where the marketing team was, but did they seriously think that, like, putting a toy store in the middle of a canyon is going to be a good marketing campaign? I don't know.
I would just have to say that is just basically a waste of space. Who would go to the Grand Canyon to buy toys?
It's not the Grand Canyon, but it's in a canyon. But still, yeah, why the heck would you go to a canyon and buy toys when you could?
And how would you get down there?
I don't know. Like, maybe they have, like, an elevator or something.
Yeah, an elevator made out of sand, something like that.
Made out of sand.
What? It's all, I mean, you can't get down there. The only possible way is either a helicopter or a dugout elevator.
Okay, so the controls. It supports two options, which is Wii Balance Board and Wii Remote Alone. Wii Balance Board was okay, and it can give you a lot of replayability if you're trying to master it. Now, the game was, the regular Wii Remote was pretty good. It could use some improvement, but basically you're holding it up, the pointer, to where the IR pointer is pointing to the wall or the ceiling, and you then twist, like, move it forward, backwards, left, right, to go down, left, right, up. You know, I think you get it. But you know, it's simple, but it can sometimes be unresponsive, and I guess maybe if they included Wii Motion Plus, they could probably work better. I can't say for sure, but that's just a guess. But maybe they could give it a test run or something.
Yeah, the one thing I would probably have to say about the controls is that I think maybe they could use a little bit more, like, work and all. Like, adding it more, like, connection better, so it'll be easier to turn and all. But the only thing is that there's only one button you use on the Wii Remote, and that's only A. So you don't get that much of button pressing, and that's...
Okay, well, what about the missiles? Because I know you have to shoot missiles in the game. Like, is that A or is that B?
It's A, because... Okay. Because I don't know why it's... Okay. It's just really confusing.
Okay, well, the gameplay, there's several different missions in the course of three acts. Act 1, Act 2, Act 3, and then a bonus act. Act 1 is basically just a training, Act 2 is where it gets a lot harder, and it's pretty fun. The shooting missiles can be very fun. What did you think about shooting missiles?
Well, that was very fun, except for one problem. It's the aiming, like, it's when you're trying to fly at the same time and shoot. There's no way it can either, like, it comes out from the bottom of it, so if you want to try to hit a target that's really high, you have to go extremely high up or like, aim up, and while you're going up, then fire it, so it makes it very tough.
Okay, so you're saying that maybe if they included a co-op to where one person controls the helicopter and the other person controls the pointer to shoot?
Yeah.
That might work better? Okay.
Or at least have Wii Remote and Nunchuck where you could aim and shoot.
Oh, okay, yeah, okay. So the replayability in this game, I don't think there's that much replayability, because there's not really much to unlock, if there is any at all, really, besides the bonus. You can buy other helicopters, and if you saw my Dolphin review, it had downloadable content, and so does this game. And downloadable content on My Dolphin wasn't too good, and this was where I think maybe the downloadable content is pretty good, because you're paying $1 for a helicopter out of 10 helicopter designs, and they do look pretty cool. Another thing that I thought was interesting is that each helicopter can change the gameplay. Like, one could have unlimited ammo, or the other one could carry more passengers. And so I think, yeah, you know, that could be good, but still, it still could use some unlockables. And there's not much replayability in this game. Now, if I were to choose to buy it or skip it and give it out of 10, I'd probably give the game a 6 out of 10. It is it's a pretty good game, and it's fun. I mean, it's only $5, so I'm going to say buy it, but you probably could get other games that are worth $5, like BitTrip Beat or some of those other games. But just remember that, you know, you're only paying $5, so you don't, I mean, I think it has enough content. It has more content than My Dolphin to do a buy. So what do you think?
Well, you're earning points as you're flying, like these point things, but they don't do anything, so it would be best if you could use those to buy helicopters and all that kind of stuff. I hate the fact that you have to use Wii points to buy those.
Okay, so would you buy it or skip it?
I would say buy it and just watch some more reviews to see what you think, make the decision from there. But I would have to say buy it.
Okay. What would you get it out of 10?
I'm going to probably give it a 6.5.
6.5, really? Okay. Well, thanks for watching this review. If you have any questions, concerns, or any review requests, please email us at welike2review@gmail.com or leave a comment on the video or PM us. Thanks for watching.